Today I'd like to discuss the Oilers' recent trade for defenseman Griffin Reinhart. When the Oilers were on the clock at the 16th pick, I was pumped. Boston had just passed over some highly ranked players, it was a super deep draft, and there was a handful of teams that didn't have a first-round selection. The value of the 16th selection was about as high as it possibly could have been. And then they announced that there was a trade with the Islanders, and I was like,
oh, I'm so happy, I can't even feel my arms!
Thinking maybe Travis Hamonic is coming the other way. And then they announced that it was the 16th pick and the 33rd pick for Reinhart, and I was like,
what?
And then they showed Lowe and McTavish at the Oilers' draft table, and I was like, did they influence Chiarelli to make this trade? Fans of both teams were split right down the middle on this deal. They either loved it or hated it. Initially, I really didn't like it. First off, the Oilers gave up too much, plain and simple. There isn't really any way around that. What made it look worse than it really was the fact that Calgary fleeced Boston in the Dougie Hamilton deal. And with Boston selecting a guy they could have gotten in round two with the 15th pick, it was almost as though Calgary got Hamilton for 3 second round picks. Edmonton's pick was 16th overall, but considering the depth of the draft and the ranking of Barzal, it was almost like trading a top 10 pick and a high second rounder for a former top 5 pick who seems to have been surpassed by players taken after him. The optics of the deal just don't look good on paper. Having said that, it's not like Chiarelli should be taken out into the street and shot for swinging this deal. Now, Kevin Lowe was always a big Reinhart fan, so there was immediate concern that he is still contributing to player personnel decisions. But once Bob Green was interviewed, it became clear that this move was based on his advice. I know people were also worked up about the fact that the Oilers just seemed to be collecting former Oil Kings in the draft, but shortly after that, they moved one of their Oil King prospects out. I like that Chiarelli pulled the trigger on the deal because of Green's input. This goes back to Bob Nicholson's comments about loyalty, teamwork, and trust. You have to trust the guys working under you and act on that trust. If Green says the kid is going to pan out, I'm glad Chiarelli heeded his advice. And I also like the fact that this was a risky move. Unlike his predecessors, Chiarelli isn't paralyzed by the fear of making a bad trade. The one comment that stood out to me on social media was, why did the Islanders give up on this kid just a few years after they drafted him? The Oilers should beware. I'm sorry, but I'll take a chance on a young player the Islanders have given up on any day. I won't deny that Reinhart's skating needs some work, but he's still too young to be written off as a failed prospect, especially because defensemen take longer to develop. It's not like this guy is Patrick Stefan or something.
Stefan steals and he'll ice it. Oh, at least I thought he was gonna until he blew it. That's unbelievable. Here come the Oilers the other way and Hemsky's loose. Hemsky, he scored! Can you believe what we just saw?
Man, I could watch that play all day. Anyway, there are a few things that I do really like about this deal. One, Reinhart has played in Edmonton and had tremendous success there. He's going to be comfortable in his new surroundings, and just like all the other new faces coming in, he doesn't associate coming to Rexall Place every day with negative experiences. Two, this move corrected a mistake that was made at the 2012 draft when the Oilers should have drafted or traded for a defenseman. Three, if Reinhart even develops into a solid third pairing guy in the mold of, let's say, Steady Steve, that's fine by me. Imagine being a right winger coming down the boards in a few years and having to go up against Nurse, Klefbom, or Reinhart every single shift. So this deal has some pros and cons to it, but considering Chiarelli's entire body of work with the Oilers so far, I don't have a problem with it, because every single other move he has made has been a clear upgrade for the organization. If Reinhart never becomes a full-time NHLer and Barzal becomes a legit second-line center for the Islanders, the move's not going to cripple the Oilers. But hopefully that doesn't happen. I really enjoy hearing your feedback, so please like and comment. And if you want to see more of my Oiler blogs in the future, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.